Hey guys, welcome back to Breezy Reef and an updated video on my 90-gallon mixed reef. And as you can see, the system is still running, it's still here. I know it's been a while since my last update. And overall, the system is doing good. In my last video, for those of you that watched it, I had lost a couple SPS corals that bleached out due to a faulty test kit, and I was getting wrong alkaline levels. And they were in fact really low, and my test kit was showing them to be fine, and a lot of my corals took a hit because of that. And since then I've been dosing Reef Fusion. It's made by Seachem. It's a two-part buffer system, and I've been dosing daily about 30 milliliters of each, and some of the SPS are looking better. Other ones really just the color hasn't returned like the color of old. So I decided about a week and a half ago to up the amount of dosing, and now I'm doing 60 milliliters of each per day, pretty much per day. Sometimes I skip a day, but I'm gonna run with this for a while and see if hopefully I can get some of that vibrant color back on these SPS. Like I said, the growth rate seems really good. I'm still fragging some of these back, and you can see the big green acro in the middle there is growing like crazy. My supernatural monopora has created a really good sized shelf, but let's see if I can zoom in for you. But really not the color. I mean, all the polyps are out, it looks good, but the base color, that it's kind of supposed to be a dark brown with the kind of teal polyps, and that base color is really light. It's almost like a tan, and you can see there near the edges a lot lighter. So it still seems healthy. Even my green bird's nest right next to it, really good color on the lower portion, but the upper portion still kind of bleached out is how it's looking to me. This one really didn't suffer too much. This is my tricolor Velita, and that one looks good. The purple stylo is not near as dark purple as it used to be. This acro is really hardy, not an issue. The one that really isn't looking good is my sunset monopora. I mean, it's just really lost a lot of that, the bright orange color that's on the base of it. The polyps are still green, those look good, but kind of discouraging. So, and this ORA green monopora too is just not near as green as it used to be. So I'm doing that increased dosing. The other issue I'm kind of noticing is even this LPS, this is my large colony of a frog spawn. You can see the heads that are kind of underneath are really a vibrant green, and these upper ones just kind of really faded out. And that's been going on for a while, and I think that might have to do with the fact that a few months ago I lowered my Reef Bright LEDs right onto the tank. And for those of you that are following my videos, you can see I actually suspended the light fixture again. It's now about 6 or 7 inches off of the surface of the water like I originally had it. At one point, I took it off the cable system and just set it right onto the tank, thinking that the added light would benefit my SPS corals. I haven't really seen any change there, and I've been dealing with the other issue with the low alkaline. So I decided to raise the fixture back up, thinking maybe that increased light was adversely affecting my LPS corals, like my frog spawn here. Anyone watching this video, I mean, if you want to chime in, if you think otherwise, have any other ideas for me or suggestions, I mean, I'd appreciate any input. The colony still seems really healthy. There's new heads coming in as usual. I have to frag this thing every few months, but it's just that color. It's just not what I'm used to seeing, and doesn't seem as healthy as it could be. So that's about it on that, guys. Otherwise, the system, still very happy with it. I just cleaned it earlier today. It's looking really good, and I'll give you a couple other angles before I end this video, give you some close-ups, and also fill you in on one other update on one of my fish that I had to take out of this system. So one other thing I wanted to show you is I had that issue with my Desjardini Sailfin Tang getting harassed by some other fish in this tank, and I never actually saw it go down, but I think it was my larger Tamini Tang, which is right there. And my Desjardini was just not looking good. She was eating really well, but just getting more and more munched, and as of the last week was just looking in pretty sad shape. So actually last night I finally caught her when just my actinic lighting was on. I have been trying to get her for a while, but I decided to give it a shot under the blue lighting, and sure enough I nabbed her. And for now I put her into the 24 gallon nano cube. I know that's a really small tank for a tang, but in this situation, I mean, I just had to get her out of here. I don't think she was going to last too much longer being in this system and getting harassed the way she was. So I put her into the nano cube last night. I'm hoping she's already looking a little better, and I'm hoping I can kind of nurse her back to health, and then ultimately I'm going to take her back to the local fish store and return that fish, and maybe at some point I can get another fish for the 90 gallon here. So that's the update on the fish. That's it for now. I'll come back to you soon with some more videos. Maybe I'll show you a look at the tang recovering in my nano cube. But that's it for now. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you soon.